German sweater with the letter in front.
Welcome to our 2020 Walsh High School W Club Banquet. I'm Ryan Rehnquist, principal at Walsh High School. I have some good news and some bad news for you. The bad news is we won't be able to pat you on the back or shake your hand for the amazing things you did on the athletic playing fields this year. The good news is you made history. This is our first and hopefully last virtual W Club banquet. I'd like to begin with a long list of thank yous. There are so many people who make WHS athletics possible. Thank you to our athletic director, Alyssa Rehnquist, for the endless hours you spend scheduling, organizing, and preparing for activities. Thank you to our transportation director, Ronnie Tate, for making our travel to and from events a first-class experience. Thank you to our bus drivers, Ronnie Tate, Doug Ray, Bill Forgy, and Jana Forgy. Thank you for keeping our most precious commodity safe. Thank you to our announcers, Kyle Sniff and Steve Cogburn, for making the game experience a ton of fun for everyone. Thank you to all of our teachers and staff for volunteering their time to run the gate, scoreboard, or keep book. We appreciate your time and positive attitude. Thank you to our football chain gang, Scott McDonald, Bill Pennick, Tyler Hufford, Steve Doner, Josh Forgy, Kate Alton, Colin Hare, and Colby Sires. Thank you to our superintendent, Mrs. Hun, and to our school board for supporting Walsh Eagle Athletics. Thank you to Mrs. Jones for all of your hard work. We appreciate all the time and effort you put forth in creating videos and athletic film. Now, the moment you've all been waiting for, let's honor our amazing student athletes. First, I'd like to recognize our W Club officers. President Dylan Rehnquist, Vice President Coy McDonald, Secretary Daniil Doyle, Treasurer Saul Carrillo. Next, our head coaches honoring their athletes. Let's start off with Bill Forgy, Junior High Football.
This time for Junior High Football. Boys had a great season. The team went 6-2. Had a lot of fun with these boys. We had 18 boys this year. We had 8 eighth graders: Layton, Gavin, Nolan, Axton, Cole, Mick, Tyler, and Adrian. We also had 4 seventh graders: had Connor, Trace, Ethan, and Cody Malone. Had 6 sixth graders: Tate, Ty, Malachi, Cody Tate, Maddox, Jeremiah Dela Cruz. 2 of these boys were from Vilas: Ethan Barwick and Cody Malone. Cody didn't get to play because of a broken ankle. Jeremiah played half the season and then moved away. Again, as I said, the boys had a great season. They worked hard all season, and I'm hoping the 8th graders move on up to the high school level, because I think it could be exciting. Thanks, guys.
Swing my heart across the line, and my face is flashing signs. Seek it out and ye shall find. Old, but I'm not that old. Young, but I'm not that bold. And I don't think the world is sold. I'm just doing what we're told. I feel something so right. Kills me, makes me feel alive. I've been losing sleep, dreaming about the things that we could be. Baby, I've been praying hard.
Coach Forgy, high school football.
Hello, Coach Forgy here for high school football. What a crazy year. Wasn't sure whether we were going to have a team or not. Then Dylan, Remy came out, which gave us 7 for the team. Then we had to worry about whether we were going to forfeit our first game with Branson because Brandon didn't get cleared right away for his physical, and Justin got backed off his horse and broke his nose. Thankfully, the doctor cleared Justin and it gave us 6 to play Branson with. We finished the season 2-7, did make the playoffs with the strength of our schedule. We played 4 of our 9 games with 6 boys. Had a lot of great compliments on the boys for how hard they played from other coaches. Had 4 girls help us. Janet and Cadence helped with stats. Chelsea filmed, and Bobby helped with stats and filming. Layton, Nolan, Ashton, and Tyler, and Connor helped us during the season as managers, filmers, and on the sidelines during games. Some stats for the boys, right quick. Coy got to play 5 games because he twisted that ankle. He's our senior. Had 279 yards passing, 283 yards rushing, 120 yards receiving, had 85 tackles and 8 TDs. Dylan got to play all 9 games, another senior, had 70 yards passing, 16 rushing yards, 252 yards receiving, 29 tackles, and 7 TDs. Brendan, our last senior, played 8 games, had 628 yards passing, 333 yards rushing, 79 yards receiving, 68 tackles, and 3 TDs. Kevin, our junior, played all 9 games, had 30 yards passing, had 338 yards rushing, 269 yards receiving, 81 tackles, and 9 TDs. Saul, another junior, played all 9 games, had 106 yards receiving, 31 tackles, and 2 TDs. Remy, the junior, had 30 yards receiving, 19 tackles, and 1 TD. Justin, our lone sophomore, had 273 yards rushing, 161 yards receiving, and 81 tackles, and 6 TDs. I also forgot to mention, Saul, on his extra points, went 20 for 31. So, done a really good job kicking. Coy, Brendan, made all conference. Losing these three seniors, going to be hard. It felt hard. I really enjoyed coaching them, and I want to thank all 7 of these men, these young men, for keeping Walsh Eagle football alive. Thanks.
We'll be right back.
Our next presenter is Aubrey Powers, junior high volleyball.
Hi everyone, this is Coach Powers. I'm going to start with junior high volleyball. First, I want to thank Coach Desiree Mandel for helping our team and assisting us this year. You did a great job, and I'm very thankful to have you. And our girls are very blessed to have you as their coach as well. So we had 14 girls out for volleyball this year for junior high volleyball. Coach Mandel and I saw a ton of growth in each of the ladies that we worked with. I'm just going to start with telling you a little bit about each one and what positions they played. Keely Smith, as an eighth grader, played middle front and left back for our team, the A team this season. She also played middle back a little bit, and I saw a lot of growth in her serving consistency and in her passing and hitting skills. So Larissa played setter for us on the A team, and I admired Larissa's ability to lead and really work hard for her teammates. She definitely improved as a setter and server, and I also saw her hustling, getting on the floor. She's not afraid to dive for a ball, which I'm really excited about to continue working with her next season with this. Emily Hume played setter for our A team this season. She grew in her serving consistency and got stronger and more consistent with setting and also with passing. Jamie Hume played outside hitter and middle back and left back for our A team this year. I saw a determination with Jamie to improve in her serving, which she did. She has a great work ethic and attitude, so I'm excited to continue to see what Jamie can do with those qualities. Melissa Rangel played outside hitter and middle back for our team. On the A team, she really improved in her serving consistency and in her ability to dig and play defense in the back row. I also saw a lot of improvement in her hitting footwork and in her hitting timing. Maribel Carrillo, another seventh grader. So Emily, Jamie, Melissa, and Maribel are seventh graders, played middle back and middle front for our A team this season. Maribel is very competitive. She also improved in her hitting footwork and timing and in her passing, and she was able to be a vocal leader for us in the back row, which was really nice. The rest of the players that I'm going to talk about are sixth graders. Yanady Calzada played setter, outside hitter for our team this season. She played left back and right back. She played on both A team and the B team, and I really saw a lot of improvement in her ability to come in on the A team. She did that in the Baca County League tournament and served very well for our team at that tournament. So that was really exciting to see with Yanady. Jocelyn Tedder played outside hitter and left back for the B team this season. I saw her grow in her serving consistency and her strength. And she also came through for our team behind the service line in pressure situations too. Reese Mandel played middle back and middle front for our B team this season. She came into pass in the back row some on the A team for a few matches, and I saw her work hard at the service line and work to improve that, as well as her passing and her hitting timing, her passing abilities and her hitting footwork and timing. Zoe Miller played outside hitter and left back for our B team this season and really improved in her ability to serve consistently and to serve well under pressure. Her confidence grew, and her passing and hitting skills also improved. Kayla Pinnick played as a setter for the B team and played outside hitter middle back for the A team. She helped our team in her ability to serve consistently and to do so under pressure. She had to play different roles on different teams, which is difficult, and she hustled and grew in her ability to pass and play defense, as well as in her setting and hitting footwork. Reagan Casey played outside hitter for the B team this season. She really improved in her serve and gained more confidence throughout the season in her passing and serving abilities. Avery Kunzman played middle back and middle front for our A team and B team this season, and she also improved in her ability to serve consistently. She grew in her footwork and her skills, and she grew as a vocal leader in the back row, and she's a good worker and has a great attitude, so that's exciting to see her growth. Tierra Cook played setter for our B team this season and really brought a lot of good to our team. She helped us a lot in serving and in passing and setting. It was nice to have Tierra on our team as well. So Coach Mandel and I are really, we really enjoyed watching these girls improve, and we are excited to see the continued growth and the work that they continue to put in the future. We know that through hard work and great attitudes that a lot of great things are possible for this group. So thank you for watching my video, and I hope you guys have a great day.
Here is Coach Powers again with high school volleyball.
First, I want to thank our coaches, Coach Desiree Mandel and Coach Shelby Doner, for helping our team this season. And I want to thank them for their passion and patience and perspective that they brought to our team. Very grateful for both of you and all that you've taught me, and for sharing your gifts with our team to make us better. I'm also thankful for Reese. I'd like to thank Reese Mandel and Ava Alley for helping our team this season as managers for us. We finished our season with a winning record of 12-11, and although we didn't finish as strong as we planned to, we are really hopeful for what we're able to do together in the future. Our league record was 2-2, and I'd just like to say a little bit about each player on our team. I'd like to start by talking about our setters. First, Danielle Doyle, a junior, played setter and outside hitter for our team this season. I saw her improve in her ability to lead our team, and she continued to be strong behind the service line for us. Danielle did a great job of making decisions for our team and making things happen, being creative and smart in her playmaking, and I saw improvement in her defense and her digging abilities also. Jensen Rehnquist, a freshman, played as a setter for our team and also outside hitter. Her ability to spot serve and perform well under pressure was something that really impressed me this season. I knew that she was a competitor, as I've coached her for 3 years prior to this one, but when we played Wiley at home at the beginning of the season, I saw a fierceness from Jensen that I hadn't seen before. She really improved in her hitting consistency and became a strong outside hitter as well as a strong setter for our team. Mackenzie Pennick played middle front, middle back, and left back at times for us this season. Her serving consistency and spot serving improved a great deal from the 2018 season. She led our team in kills and blocks and was a strong force for us at the net. Brooke McDonald also played middle front and middle back for us. She led our team in serving consistently and really helped us behind the service line. Spot serving was an area where Brooke grew a great deal over the season, and she did a great job of covering the floor and playing defense in the back row, as well as talking to her teammates and being a leader on defense. Rochelle Casey played left back and right front for our team this season. She improved in her spot serving and also improved at being consistent and serving under pressure for our team. Talisa Turner played right front and left back. Her ability to be consistent behind the service line improved over the season, and she really helped our team in the back row by hustling, getting on the floor, and playing aggressive defense. Liberty Curry played outside hitter, left back, and middle back for our team. I saw much growth in Liberty's skills this season. Her serve improved, as well as her defense and passing, her hitting timing, and footwork also became areas where Liberty was growing and improving. Alyssa Cook practiced with our team but was unable to play at the varsity level. However, she did play in several JV matches. Alyssa improved in her confidence behind the service line, as well as her hitting footwork and timing and her passing. Tiana Sharp didn't play with our team this season, but was consistently at practice and games supporting her teammates. We look forward to having Tiana play with our team again and hope that she's able to be on the court with us in the fall. We did have two players that made the All-Conference, the Arc Valley All-Conference second team. Those players were Mackenzie Pinnick and Brooke McDonald. It was a good season for our team, and I believe that we learned a great deal through it. Thank you for your time in listening to this video, and I'm grateful to be a part of the Walsh community.
Yeah. Come on.
Let's move on to winter sports. Josh Whitler with Junior High Boys Basketball.
The Walsh Eagle Junior High Boys had a great year. Coach Hare and I have enjoyed working with them, some of them, for 4 years now. It's been awesome to witness the way that they have grown, improved, learned about the game, and become good players and good teammates. Last year, I told this group that the best was yet to come. This year, they got to see a glimpse of what that means. They were able to play in a couple of championship games, getting runner-up twice. They were just 4 points shy of a league championship. They just ran out of time. There were quite a few close games, though. Those are awesome to have. They're the key to basketball development. Some of them we won, and some of them we didn't. We were able to learn a few different defenses, although by far, this group's favorite was man-to-man. We were able to develop, make our offense a little more well-rounded, with the post working on rebounds and scoring from the post. Our guards looking to do a better job of rebounding, drive, make good passes, as well as shoot. One area of improvement that's easily overlooked was that of free throw shooting. In fact, it won a couple of games for these guys. Coach and I were especially proud of the defense that this team played. They are tenacious. They experienced some tough losses, but that only fueled their desire to improve. And improve they did. Every single player. They even got to avenge a couple of those losses. This team's never been tall, but they've always played with more passion and more heart than opponents. I love that about them. It's something that will pay dividends for them throughout life. Mick, Cole, Axton, Nolan, Tyler, Gavin, Adrian, and Layton. As eighth graders, you have all improved greatly in your time in junior high, as leaders, as players, and as young men. I look forward to working with you in high school. Connor, Trace, Cody, Aiden, Ty Hoffman, Maddox, and Tate. It will be awesome to get back to work next year as you continue to improve and work hard. Although you got to catch a glimpse of the great things you can accomplish, don't let up. Don't stop looking for ways to improve and keep your enthusiasm for the game high. Great job, gentlemen.
been about 17. Things going strong, playing my favorite song. And I could tell it wouldn't be long, that he was with me, yeah, me. And I could tell it wouldn't be long, that he was with me, yeah, me. It's all the same. So can I take you home where we can be alone? Next we're moving on. He was with me, yeah, me. Next we're moving on. He was with me, yeah, me.
Here's Coach Whitler with high school boys basketball.
Good evening, everyone. What a season for our Walsh Eagle men. It was unique, special, and uncommon in many ways. It was full of quality basketball, tough defense, running the floor, sharp shooting, hard practicing, risking boldly, and even had a few dunks sprinkled in. It was a championship year. I want to highlight a few of the things that made it just that. For the last 3 years, we've talked about getting C's. Some of you have heard this: character, courage, commitment, challenge. The list goes on. The ultimate C was being a champion. This year, we started the year by looking at being uncommonly common, because champions are not common, but the things they do are. I want to share some of the uncommonly common things the team did, which are also some of the things that will be remembered from this season. First, we've had some uncommon experiences as a team, scoring 8 points in just 42 seconds to get a win against Greeley County at the Border War. Coming back from down 10 at half against Stanton County to beat them on the road for the second time. A fast-paced championship game at the Christmas tournament, a rematch that we were looking forward to at state. Playing an outstanding game on the road to beat Kim, and beating them again in the district championship game. A game that demonstrated the maturity that this team had. We didn't shoot particularly well and had to really work and find other ways to score, clamp down on defense. Of course, it's exhilarating to think about beating Shirah at regionals 2 years in a row and getting that first win this year at state against Marino. When reflecting on this year, hopefully you all remember Brendan getting dunks, running the floor, and every once in a while taking a shot that shouldn't have had a chance. Dylan sinking threes, snagging a rebound, or blocking a shot. Ryland making hustle plays on both ends of the court, hitting a big three and never slowing down. Austin calmly sinking free throws to ice a game, playing lockdown defense and smoothly shooting the ball. Coy snagging rebounds, making great plays, and hitting key shots. Kevin burning someone on that reverse layup, taking a charge, or hustling everywhere he went. Saul making people pay for disrespecting him at the three-point line, improving his drive, and making great plays off the bench. Paul snagging a rebound, encouraging his teammates, and improving his game. Jaron handing out assists, cheering on his teammates, and working hard to become a better player and challenge his teammates. This team won 21 games while averaging 63 points a game and holding opponents to just 49 points per game. They went undefeated in league play for the second consecutive year, got runner-up at the holiday basketball tournament, went undefeated at home, and is undefeated in 2020. They won a district championship, qualified for state for the second year in a row, was in the Final Four this year, and on a mission to find a gold ball. Dylan and Brendan made all-conference first team. Coy and Ryland received second team all-conference honors. Dylan was nominated for all-state, and Brendan and Ryland received honorable mentions. Austin spent the year locking down players and held the 1A player of the year to just 9 points. We had players coming off the bench to make solid contributions every game. This team was unstoppable on the court. In fact, it took a global pandemic to stop them. That's a pretty amazing list of accomplishments. More than those accomplishments, and remembering those games or plays, though, I'd like everyone to know what went into those things. It took trust from every individual and every player all the time. It took courage to play hard and control the things they could. It took commitment to each other, the team, and the game of basketball. Enthusiasm to play and practice hard day in and day out. Relentlessness in the pursuit of their goals and excellence. It is my hope that the players, and in turn their families, the school, and community, recognize and are proud of the growth, maturity, and character that this team has developed. That is what made these 9 individuals truly uncommon. I received 2 messages that I'd like to share with you, and are what I hope you remember the most about these gentlemen. The first was from an administrator from another school after our win in the first round of state this year. It read, "Congratulations. I'm proud of the way your players conduct themselves on the court. Good luck tomorrow." The other was from an opposing coach. "I love the way Walsh players played their butts off. You guys were tough." Notice they didn't compliment a specific shot or play. It was the way they played, like champions. I want to recognize a couple of non-visible members of our team. Coach Powers and Coach Sniff were gracious and accurate in keeping our books this year. Thank you. Parents, thank you for entrusting your sons to us. They are quality young men. And the school and community, thank you for your support this year. Thinking about the year and the uncommon ending it had, Coach and I hope that as players you have no regrets. I know that Coach and I don't. Disappointment in not being allowed to finish what we started, yes, but no regrets. Every day in practice and on the court, we did everything in our power to accomplish the goal of becoming champions. You have accomplished that goal. Champions you are, on and off the court.
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. Feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. Tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. A feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. Tonight's the night.
Next is Bill Forgy with Junior High Wrestling.
Coach Forgy again for Junior High Wrestling. What can I say? This was a fun bunch of kids to coach. We had some new wrestlers along with some veterans, and they worked hard. I want to thank the parents again for letting Coach and I keep the kids for a little while after school was out, to get a little more practice time in. We had 17 wrestlers, 8 from Walsh, 8 from Springfield, and 1 from Vilas. We had 5 eighth graders: Leighton Jones, Mick Howard, Nolan Hibbard, Heather Hancock, and Lily Viney. Had 3 seventh graders: Trace Brisendine, Cash Cooper, and Ethan Barwick. We had 9 sixth graders: Ty Hoffman, Tate Ringquist, Aiden Mabee, Malachi Esparza, Haley Hancock, Jacob Sugars, Slade Cahoon, Wyatt Cahoon, and Wyatt Herbert. We wrestled some real tough tournaments, and they worked hard. We didn't always get the win, but they always improved. Really enjoyed working with this bunch of kids. Look forward to coaching some more next year. Thank you.
About 17, he was strong, playing my favorite song, and I could tell it wouldn't be long that he was with me, yeah, me, and I could tell it wouldn't be long that he was with me, yeah, me, singing.
Here is Coach Forgy with high school wrestling.
Coach Forgy here with high school wrestling. Had three wrestlers this year, one senior, one sophomore. Boys seen some great wrestling. The boys worked really hard. Never had to worry about these three working hard. They pushed each other despite the difference in weight. In fact, we did struggle with some injuries this year. In fact, on our week off, Mr. Doner let us use his bikes to work out instead of practicing on the mat. Thank you, Mr. Doner, for letting us use your bikes. My senior, Levi Hancock, wrestled 126 this year, finished the season at 22-13 and fifth at regionals. For his career, he was two-time state qualifier, and his career record is 68-68. Braden Hancock, a sophomore, wrestled 138, fought injuries all season. Ended the season at 4-10, didn't get to wrestle at regionals because of an injury. Justin Wright, my other sophomore, wrestled 182, finished the year at 19-13, finished third at regionals, and qualified for state. Went 1-2. At state, wrestled well, but we lost our last match in overtime. Really proud of these three boys for the way they battled all season. Also have something here, and we call it rules for wrestling. And you can put any other sport in there on some of it. It's not some good ideas here for the kids. First one, never be outworked. Gotta take pride in working. Number two, don't focus on your record. Focus on getting better and going after the toughest challenges. Number three, remember, cutting weight doesn't make you a better wrestler. Four, have a purpose every practice. Stop going through the motions. Make sure you focus on areas that will make you better. Number five, stop comparing yourself to other people. Real champions compete against themselves. Number six, be thankful for the opportunity to wrestle or play any other sport. Remember, it's something you get to do, not something you have to do. Number 7, be patient. Realize that it takes time to make big improvements. Number 8, wrestle for yourself. Think about all the ways you love what you love about wrestling. Number 9, never quit. If you can't win, make the other guy tired. Push him as hard as you can. If you aren't the starter, get better each day anyway. Number 10, keep things in perspective. Faith, family, and academics come before wrestling or any other sport. God doesn't care how many titles you win, and your family will love you no matter what. And number 11, train your mind if you want to be at your absolute best. Thanks, guys.
The next presenter is Shay Sniff with Junior High Girls Basketball.
Good afternoon. I have the privilege to be able to introduce to you this year's Junior High Girls Basketball team. I'm just going to go ahead and list them off by name right now. We had our sixth graders, Yanady Calzada, Reagan Casey, Angel Flint, Avery Kunzelman, Kayla Pinnick, Reese Mundell, and Jocelyn Tedder. In seventh grade, we had Maribel Carrillo, Emily Hume, Jamie Hume, and Melissa Rangel. And in eighth grade, we had Larissa Beecham and Keely Smith. Whoa, this was an awesome team. Coach Powers and I, we just loved watching this team play with the in practice and in games. Tenacity. You guys had tenacity. You guys were so tough. And every single year, you know, we have our team gets together and we do our individual goals and our team goals. And about, honestly, every single year, everybody will say our team goals are we want to be known as the most sportsmanlike team. We want to be known as the classiest team and the team that gets along, the team that gets plays together. And of course, we had that again this year. But I was really impressed as well with the push of higher individual goals. The individual goals this year were definitely challenging. And that's what you want to see with your goals. You want to push yourself. You don't want something that's going to be easy. You want to be able to strive for something, to reach something higher that's not just within your reach from the first get-go. And you guys were having that, and that's what was so cool to see for Coach and I, was your determination to push yourself. And you guys really did, and you pushed each other. And knowing the difference and how you push each other in a loving way and to make each other better and how you see that as making you better. You guys had that. People could see that on the court, how hard you worked. And what I love too, of course, our eighth graders, they stepped up to lead by their performance. But not only that, everybody this year decided that they were going to compete. Everybody decided, hey, I'm going to do something here too. It didn't matter who, what age, or anything. And that is great. Don't limit yourself by your age. Don't limit yourself by your position. everybody can participate and everybody can compete. And you guys did that. That was cool. The whole team stepped up to that. And whenever we look at growth, you know, a lot of coaches, they might want to be able to give, hey, I'm going to give the most improved player award to so-and-so. And Coach Powers and I were like, there's no way you can give that award to any one person on our team. We had so much growth. Every single player had so much growth across the board that we couldn't give an award for that. You guys, we started out our season basically kind of pretty raw, bare bones. And then by the end of the season, you guys, your performance was amazing. I was so proud of how you guys ended our season. You pushed so hard. And of course, at the end, what I love to see is whenever we do have our exit meetings and we do sit down with you as players and you look and you say, what did we do well this year? Every single one of you said, we had a good season. Not one single one of you, not one, talked about our record. And I love that because sometimes you're not going to have the record you want. And you guys were all focusing on your growth. Of course, Coach and I, that's what we focus on too, is growth. And it's cool to see you guys doing that too. And I just want to encourage you to keep that up with every area of your life. Keep up that desire to look at how you're growing. And not always look at what's happening as the results. Look at the work you put in. Make sure that's your focus. Make your priority be about growth and purpose, and you're going to accomplish anything you put your mind to. Keep working hard. Keep encouraging one another. Keep encouraging your community, and know that Coach and I are always here for you. Send a text out, message us anytime. We're here for you.
Turn it up.
I'm Ryan Rehnquist, head girls basketball coach at Walsh High School. John Wooden once said, "No written word nor spoken plea can teach our youth what they should be, nor all the books on the shelves. It's what the teachers are themselves." Our girls basketball players had a tremendous opportunity this year to work every day with two amazing teachers. To Coach Powers and Coach Doner, thank you for your time and dedication to this team. Your words of encouragement and your positive attitude inspired everyone on our team, including me. Going to work every day was a ton of fun due to our amazing assistant coaches. Our assistants allowed us to play 5-on-5, but most importantly, our assistant coaches taught our young athletes how to compete, play hard, be tough, display pride, and show respect towards others. Our list of assistant coaches was like an all-star team. Thank you, Coach Powers, Coach Doner, Coach Sniff, Coach Sharp, Coach Smith, Coach Freed, Coach Turner, Coach Cole, and to our athletic director, Alyssa Rehnquist, for being a part of the 2019-2020 Walsh Lady Eagle basketball season. We could not have done it without you. We all know about the hardships we had to endure this season. I'm not even going to mention them because my fervent intent for our players is that they remember the season for all the positive experiences they had. I know I will remember the night Rochelle Casey grabbed 17 rebounds at home against Shira. How about the night Talisa Turner poured in 4 threes at the holiday tournament versus Eads? For me, the best part about coaching girls basketball was being able to jam out to Katy Perry and Miley Cyrus on bus rides. You know what made it even better? Tiana Sharp's delicious homemade treats. We were sad that Tiana didn't get to play this year, but she was still an awesome teammate. Danielle Doyle's clutch shooting at home versus Moscow helped lead us to our first win of the season. Brooke McDonald's double-double versus Shiraz proved she wasn't in junior high anymore. I have 4 words for you. Chelsea Brizendine. Rodman rebounding. If that didn't bring a smile to your face, nothing will. What an amazing addition to our basketball team Chelsea was. Kinsey Pinnock proved that practice isn't all that it's cracked up to be. After a few months off, she poured in 6 points, 9 rebounds, 4 assists, and 1 block shot as the Lady Eagles took Wiley to 2 overtimes. I still get goosebumps when I think about that game. I know I'll never forget my favorite play. I whispered to our freshman point guard, "Hit it." Jensen Rehnquist promptly replied by draining a 3 from NBA territory. I have so many fond memories of our time together. I hope you do too. When I give out individual awards, I always give out awards that any player on our team can achieve. I think toughness in sports is a key ingredient towards success. It does not take talent to take charges or to get on the floor for loose balls, but it does take toughness. We call our Tough Player Award the Floor Burn Award. The Floor Burn Award is given to the player who takes the most charges during the season. This year, we had 2 players take charges in a game. The Floor Burn Award goes to Jensen Rehnquist and Brooke McDonald. Another award that any player on our team can achieve is our Free Throw Ladder Champion. It does take excellent form to make free throws, but it also takes a lot of hard work. Good free throw shooters typically spend a lot of time shooting free throws. This year's Free Throw Ladder Champion is Jensen Rehnquist. We like to say that basketball teams are made from November through March, and that basketball players are made from March through November. If you are a basketball player, then getting better in the offseason should be your number 1 priority. I encourage all of our players to hit the hard courts and work on becoming a better ball handler and shooter. The player that Coach Powers and Coach Doner and I felt like improved the most from the conclusion of last season until the end of this season was Talisa Turner. Talisa's toughness and willingness to play defense stood out most to her coaches. Finally, we have some postseason honors to award. Jensen Rehnquist made the Border Wars All-Tournament Team, the Arkansas Valley Second Team All-Conference, and the Chassa All-State Honorable Mention Team. Jensen led Class 1A in free throws made and blocked shots. She was 7th in the state in double-doubles with 10. Jensen was 9th in the state in scoring and 10th in the state in three-pointers made and rebounding. Jensen etched her way into the record books by making 24 free throws in a game, which is the most any player has made in a game in the state of Colorado in any classification. Congratulations to all of our players. I hope that you get out of next season whatever you put into this offseason.
Hello, I'm Alyssa Rehnquist, the athletic director at Walsh High School. At this time, I will announce each athlete and what sports they participated in. Yanady Calzada, volleyball and basketball. Reagan Casey, volleyball, basketball. Malachi Esparza, football, wrestling. Angel Flint, basketball. Maddox Gorley, football, basketball. Ty Hoffman, football, basketball, wrestling. Avery Kunzelman, volleyball, basketball. Aiden Mabee, basketball. Zoe Miller, volleyball. Reese Mandel, volleyball, basketball. Kayla Pinnick, volleyball, basketball. Tate Rehnquist, football, basketball, wrestling. Jocelyn Tedder, volleyball, basketball. Trace Brizendine, football, basketball, wrestling. Maribel Carrillo, volleyball, basketball. Emily Hume, volleyball, basketball. Jamie Hume, volleyball, basketball. Connor McDonald, football, basketball. Melissa Rangel, volleyball, basketball. Cody Tate, football, basketball. Adrian Alvarez, football, basketball. Larissa Beecham, volleyball, basketball. Axton Bishop, football, basketball. Leighton Jones, football, basketball, wrestling. Nolan Hibbard, football, basketball, wrestling. Mick Howard, football, basketball, wrestling. Gavin McCall, football, basketball. Tyler Pinnick, football, basketball. Keely Smith, volleyball, basketball. Cole Tedder, football, basketball. Congratulations, Eagles. We are so proud of your hard work, dedication, and loyalty to our school and community. At this time, I will announce each athlete and the sports they participated and lettered in. Liberty Curry, volleyball, track. Brooke McDonald, volleyball, basketball. Jensen Rehnquist, volleyball, basketball, track. Talisa Turner, volleyball, basketball, track. Chelsea Brizendine, football manager, basketball. Rochelle Casey, volleyball, basketball. Alyssa Cook, volleyball, track. Jaren Freiberger, basketball. Cadence Kunzelman, football manager, basketball manager. Justin Wright, football, wrestling. Saul Carrillo, football, basketball, track. Daniil Doyle, volleyball, basketball. Remy Hale, football. Paul Lovato, basketball. Mackenzie Pinnick, volleyball, basketball. Kevin Rodriguez, football, basketball, track. Tiana Sharp, volleyball, basketball. Austin Cook, basketball. Brendan Hodges, football, basketball. Rylan McCall, basketball. Coy McDonald, football, basketball. Dylan Rehnquist, football, basketball, track. Congratulations, Eagles. We are so very proud of your hard work, dedication, and loyalty to our school and community. Thank you.
It is my honor for my first time to present the Alley Athletic Memorial Award. The Alley Athletic Memorial Award was established in 1978 at Walsh High School in memory of Daryl and Joe Alley. This award is to be presented to a senior boy or girl who is selected as the outstanding senior athlete. Method of selection. The student must have attended Walsh High School for at least 2 years and participated in a varsity sport for at least 2 years. The high school coaching staff will recommend names to be voted upon by April 15th. Voting will be by ballot, and the entire faculty of Walsh High School, as well as administrators, will be eligible to vote. The award will be presented in the spring at the Athletic Awards Banquet. Candidates will be selected based on athletic achievement, scholarship, leadership, all-around abilities, moral responsibility, and personality. It is my honor and privilege to present the Alley Athletic Memorial Award in honor of my uncles Daryl and Joe Alley. The 2020 Alley Athletic Memorial Award is presented to Mr. Dylan Rehnquist. Thank you for your time in watching the Walsh High School Athletic Awards Banquet. It is my honor to be a coach and teacher at Walsh High School. Thank you.
What's a virtual W Club banquet without a little surprise? Our guest speaker's family is full of former great Walsh High School athletes. His dad won 6 state championships at Walsh High School, including the state's first ever Triple Crown. Our surprise guest is a former athlete himself, but he is better known as an actor and producer. From Hollywood, California, I'm proud to introduce Mr. Zachary Ty Bryan.
Hey, Walsh High School athletes. How you doing? This is Zachary Bryan. Probably most of you don't know who I am, but my family originates from Walsh. I don't know if you guys know, my grandfather is Harold Bryan. He's at the old folks' home there in Walsh right now. But I'm also related to the Villers, Janet Larry, Kelsey Chance, we're the Bryans. My father was a really big athlete in Walsh as well. I know he holds a bunch of state records and state championships, both basketball and football. So I spoke to your principal and he asked me to make a little video for you guys. So I wanted to let you know and kind of give you a little boost as we move on to the future during these very uncertain times. So a little bit about me. I was actually groomed to be an athlete. As you know, my father comes from Walsh, ended up playing football at the University of Northern Colorado. My cousin's Brady Quinn, he played in the NFL, now is a commentator for college football. So I was kind of groomed to be that, and somehow my path or my career kind of took off in a creative direction. Most of you are probably way too young to remember, but I was on a TV show called Home Improvement. It was the number one show in the 90s. And that was kind of a turning point in my career. But what I always took forward and what I've always used in everything that I've done is sports teaches you so many different things that you're going to just use throughout your life. From the idea of teamwork, that there's not one person that ever makes it happen. It's really everybody together going after that common goal. To discipline, knowing how to eat right, knowing what you have to do the night before games, your preparation. You know, I always say that success is when preparation meets opportunity. You guys are all going to have tons of opportunity in life, and I pray and hope that you are prepared for that. So things don't always go the way that we expect them. And I think that where I can relate to you guys this year, you know, with COVID, I know that Dylan wasn't able to finish out the basketball season. And it's probably been a very disappointing year for all of you, as well as for myself and my family. But with that adversity comes the best learning opportunities you'll ever have. Right now is a time to really think about what are the next steps you guys want to make? What direction in life do you want to go? And how are you going to, you know, set those goals and how are you going to accomplish those goals? You know, my adversity was I was planning on being an athlete. That was kind of what I wanted to do. And my mom had this thing about wanting me to be an actor in Hollywood and all these things. And it ended up taking off. So it was a total like veer off for me, but it ended up being the best thing that ever happened to me. So I guess my advice to you guys is just keep continuing down the path you're on. You've got all the fundamentals that sports teaches everybody that plays sports, from discipline to teamwork, to setting a goal, to trying to achieve that goal. And just take that on with your life. And I think you guys are gonna really be proud of yourselves and where you go. Also, adversity creates opportunities. You know, my biggest mistakes have always been the things that I've learned from. You're gonna make 99 mistakes before you catch that one wave that's gonna take you to where you wanna be. And you just wanna be prepared for that wave. So with that being said, I congratulate each and every one of you. Please keep your head up. We're doing the same over here in California. And just know that I'm here through your principal and my family. Reach out to me with any questions. You can follow me on Instagram, Zachary_Brian, Twitter's @ZTB. I'm always posting motivational stuff. I'm always posting my political opinion. My religious opinions, so you guys might like that too. And yeah, I just want you to know that I'm here for you, and I care about each and every one of you. I'm hoping to make it to Walsh soon too, so maybe we can have if any of you are still around then. I'm gonna try to put something together at the community center maybe, or at the park, and we can all hang out. Eat some good food and converse as communities, because community is what is going to take us into the future anyways. Again, congratulations. Thanks for giving me this time, and go get them. Go Eagles.
This concludes the 2020 Walsh High School W Club Banquet. I want to thank the Walsh community and our parents for supporting WHS Athletics. Thank you to all of our hardworking and dedicated coaches. You have made a significant positive impact upon our student athletes. Last, but certainly not least, thank you to our student athletes. I was extremely proud of how you represented our school and community throughout the year. Underclassmen, as you hit the athletic playing courts next year, always keep in mind, you are what every young child wants to become. Seniors, I hope you can look back upon your playing days with great pride about what you once were. Thank you.
I got a letterman sweater with the letter in front. I got for football and track. I'm proud to wear it now when I cruise around the other parts of the